Hello dear students, good morning. So in the last class we discussed about our chapter 12, ratio and proportion, and in that chapter we discussed about how to find the ratio and proportion of given numbers of A. And today we are going to start our next chapter, it is chapter 13, symmetry. Chapter 13, symmetry. So in this chapter we are going to study about symmetry. So what do you mean by symmetry? Symmetry is a common term and that we use in our day to day life. And symmetry means, and we see many things around us, and some of them are divided into, or we can separate into two equal parts, or we can divide it into equal parts in many ways. So such figures are called symmetrical figures. For example, we also say butterfly, and the butterfly we can separate, or we can divide the butterfly into two equal parts, then say symmetrical shape. So it is called symmetrical shape. So again, figures with evenly balanced proportion, it is called a symmetry. So in this chapter we are going to study about symmetry. Okay, and in your textbook page number 263, here is the first exercise in chapter 13, symmetry, exercise 13.1. in your day to day life you can see many things that is symmetrical in shape. For example, you consider blackboard symmetrical in shape. We can divide, or we can divide this into two equal parts in two ways, like this and like this. Okay, and this symmetrical in shape. So based on that, in your textbook some questions are given in your exercise 13.1. so we just go to solve that exercise 13.1.
L1 and this line L2.
like this and drawing a line like this. And if we cut into these two ways, in which way we get the mirror image of the figure? When we draw a line like this or draw the line in two, then we get the two equal parts like this. And this and this side is equal. These two sides are equal when we cut into by drawing a line in two. When we draw a line in one, then we not get two equal parts. These two parts are not equal. So the mirror image, when we get the mirror image by drawing the line in two, then which means when we fold the figure, then we get the two equal parts. So this is called the symmetrical shape, and this is the mirror image of the figure. So by drawing L2 or by drawing the line L2, then we get the symmetrical shape or mirror line, mirror image of the figure. So the answer is L2 is the mirror line of the figure. L2 is the mirror line of the figure, because the given figure is ordered about the line L2, then we get two equal parts and vice versa. So we say that L2 is the mirror line of the figure. Okay. Then the next question. Identify the shapes given below. Check whether they are symmetrical or not. Draw a line of symmetry as well. So here some figures are given. You want to identify the shapes given below. Check whether they are symmetrical or not. So you want to identify the given figures are symmetrical or not. And the first one is a key, and here the figure is like this. Is this figure is symmetrical or not? We can divide the figure into two equal parts by drawing a horizontal line. Then we get two equal parts, so it's a symmetrical shape. So the first one is symmetrical. Yes, it is a symmetrical shape. And in the beat, it's a symmetrical shape. Then the next one. Like this, then we get two equal parts. So it's a symmetrical shape. So yes, it's a symmetrical shape. Then the next question. So the question number 2 is over. Sorry, 3 is over. And the next question, 4, question number 4. Copy the following on a square paper. A square paper is what you would have used in your arithmetic notebook in earlier classes. Then complete them. Complete them such that the dotted line is the line of symmetry. So that question we will discuss in our WhatsApp. Then the next question, question number 5. And question number 5. In a figure L, is the line of symmetry. Complete the diagram to make it symmetric. So here a given figure is given. So given figure is given and the figure is like this. In the figure, L is the line of symmetry. Draw the image of the triangle and complete the diagram so that it becomes symmetric. So here, a triangle is given and L is the line of symmetry. Line of symmetry means the figure is cut into two equal parts by drawing a line and the line is called the line of symmetry and it is the line of symmetry and line is L. And here we want to make the figure become symmetric. And to make the figure become symmetric, so you just try to draw the mirror image of the figure. Okay. So you get the mirror image or symmetrical image of the given figure by drawing like this. Then the next one. So exercise 13.1 is over and in this exercise we discussed about how to draw a line of symmetry. Line of symmetry means by divide a given figure into two equal parts. We draw a line and this is called a line of symmetry. And in a rectangle, We can divide the rectangle into in this way two equal parts, and we also get cut the rectangle like this. Then we get two equal parts, and if we cut like this, then we also get two equal parts. So we get equal parts of a rectangle by cutting into more than two ways. Okay, and this is called the multiple lines of symmetry. Multiple lines of symmetry. This means if you consider a rectangle, then we can divide it into two equal parts by cutting into cutting this way, and here also cut this into two equal parts in this way. Then you get two equal parts, and another way to get the two equal parts is when you cut like this, then you get two equal parts. And another way, if you cut like this, then you get two equal parts. In this way, we can divide a given figure into two equal parts more than two ways, and drawing more than two lines of symmetry, and this is called a multiple lines of symmetry. Multiple lines of symmetry. So it is called a multiple lines of symmetry. Okay, and the next one. Then exercise 13.2. Exercise 13.2 in your textbook, page number 267. Page number 267, and this is based on multiple lines of symmetry. Okay. And the first question: find the number of lines of symmetry for each of the following shapes. So here some shapes are given. We want to draw the lines of symmetry. Okay, and here the first figure. So we can cut the figure with two equal parts by drawing a line like this. It is L1, and if we cut it into two equal parts by drawing a line L2, then we can cut it into in this way, and this. like this, then we get two equal parts. By drawing a line, L1, then we can cut the figure into like this, then we get two equal parts. Then if we cut the figure into like that, we get two equal parts. Then we can cut it into this way, we also get two equal parts. So the lines of symmetry, and this L1 into L3 and this L4. So the lines, number of lines of symmetry in the given figure is 4. There are 4, number of 4 lines of symmetry in the given figure. Then the next one. And the figure is like this. Question number C. And here we can cut the figure in this way. We get a line of symmetry. We get two equal parts, and we also cut the figure like this. Then we get two equal parts. And if we can cut it into this way, we get two equal parts and can cut it into two equal parts by drawing a line like this. So the number of lines of symmetry in the given figure is 4. There are 4 lines of symmetry in the given figure. Then the next question. And the figure D, in this figure we can cut it into only one way, then we get the two equal parts of parts by drawing a line like this. Then we get the equal parts of the figure. So the lines of symmetry, number of lines of symmetry in the given figure D is 1, 1. Number of lines of symmetry is equal to 1. And in the next question, and it says 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The figure with 5 sides. Sorry, 6 sides. It is a hexagon. It is a hexagon. So the number of lines of symmetry in a given hexagon is, let's see. We can cut into two equal parts by drawing a line like this. L1 and L2. So we can cut the given figure into two equal parts by cut it into this way, then we get L4, and we cut it into this way, L5, and cut it into center by drawing a line like this. The line of symmetry L6. The number of lines of symmetry in a hexagon is 6. So we can cut it into equal parts by drawing 6 lines. So we can say that there are 6 lines of symmetry in a hexagon. So in the given figures, question number F, let's say how we find the number of lines of symmetry in the given figure K. And the question number G, part of the figure, then it is not equal. So we can say that in any way we cannot get two equal parts of the given figure. So the given figure is, the given figure has no lines of symmetry. There is no lines of symmetry. And in the next figure, then the next question, question number 2. Copy the triangle in each of the following figures on squared paper. In each case, draw the line of symmetry, if any, and identify the type of triangle. Some of you may like to trace the figure and try paper folding first. Okay. And here some figures are given. You want to identify the lines of symmetry in the given figure. And you just identify the figure. And in the first figure, it's a triangle. It's a triangle. And if we measure the length of the three sides, then you can see that it's an isosceles triangle. It's an isosceles triangle. And the line of symmetry, we just divide it into two equal parts by drawing a line like this only. So the line of symmetry in an isosceles triangle is equal to 1. So the given triangle is an isosceles triangle. In your textbook, page number 267, and the first figure, it's an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle means two sides of the triangles are equal. So in this triangle, there is only one line of symmetry. Then the second one, and the given triangle is an isosceles triangle. This triangle is also an isosceles triangle. These two sides are of equal length and this one is not equal. Okay, so this one is also an isosceles triangle and the line of symmetry is, you can cut it into two equal parts by drawing a line like this. So the number of line of symmetry in the given triangle is 1. Then the next question. Question number C, the given triangle is an, it's a right angled triangle. And here you can see that it's a right angled triangle and the line of symmetry in the given figure is 1. We can cut into two equal parts by drawing a line like this. So it's a number of lines of symmetry in the given figure is 1. Then the next question. Line of symmetry, and in this case from lines of symmetry. Okay. And the next question, question number 3. Complete the following table. And here is the table is given. And the table includes shape, rough figures, number of lines of symmetry. And you want to identify or you want to draw the rough figures and identify the number of lines of symmetry in the given figure. Okay. And next question.
Equal parts, and by drawing a line like this, we get two equal parts. And
na two equal parts. So the number of lines of symmetry in a rectangle is equal to 2. Okay. Then the next question. An isosceles triangle. An isosceles triangle means two sides of the triangles are of equal length. So you just draw a isosceles triangle with two sides are of equal length. Then the number of lines of symmetry in an isosceles triangle means you can cut it into two equal parts only in this way. So the number of lines of symmetry in an isosceles triangle is equal to 1. Then rhombus. So you just draw a rhombus. Then we can cut it into two equal parts by drawing a line like this. So the number of lines of symmetry in a rhombus is equal to 2. Then it's a circle. So you just draw a figure of a circle, and there is infinite lines of symmetry in a circle. If you consider the center of the circle, then we can cut it into two equal parts by drawing many lines. In any ways, we cut the circles into two equal parts to connect the center. Okay. So there is infinite number of lines of symmetry in a circle. So the number of lines of symmetry in a circle is equal to infinite. There are infinite number of lines of symmetry in a circle. Then it's your so question number 3 is over. So in this class we discussed about symmetry and how to identify lines of symmetry and more multiple lines of symmetry in exercise 13.2 and up to question number 3, and we also learned about how to draw a rough figure and identify the number of lines of symmetry. Then the remaining questions that we will discuss in our next class. So you just do your homework properly and send to my WhatsApp, and we will meet with another class on next day. Okay students, not today, let's wind up our class, then we will meet with another class on next day. Thank you, have a nice day.